Welcome to KB's Plants and Orchid. Today we will see the Chinese evergreen plants in my collection. They are also known as Aglaonema, commonly known as Chinese evergreens. They are cultivated for foliage. The beautiful leaves appear in the end of the stalks. See here. They are usually linear or oval in shape. This is somewhat oval shape one. And every leaf is different. See, this one has in the middle portion white, and this has like this, and this has more of white color spreading. So like that, every little bit of difference will be different for each Aglaonema plant. It's a very easy plant to grow in the house. It belongs to the genus of flowering plant in the arum family, Araceae. They are native to tropical and subtropical regions of Asia and Guinea, commonly known as Chinese evergreen. It thrives in medium sunlight. It doesn't like direct sunlight. So where if you have a sunlight problem in house, where you are not getting enough sunlight, this is the best plant you can grow in your house. But it likes humid condition also. So it is a humidity loving plant, and it's very durable house plant. It is very easy to grow plant, and it can grow up to 3 feet tall and wide also when many small seedling plants appear nearby. Here you see two plants are there, and another third one is coming. Like this, when many plants come, it will looks like very bushy, and they can grow taller also. And Aglaonemas can be grown in water also if you don't have place to keep a big pot and all. You can get a cutting of Aglaonema, you can grow in water in a bottle. It is a air purifying plant. It absorbs the formaldehyde and saline, which is present, benzene, all those things which comes in the day to day life in the house. So it absorbs all the poisonous gases which occurs in our house, and it is toxic to pets and small children because the leaves of Aglaonema contains calcium oxalates. So you have to be very careful if you have small children and pets at home. And about the soil, it doesn't like soggy soil, but it likes moist soil and in humid climate. And if you overwater, the plant may get droopy leaves and brown tips will also occur. So like that, you have to be careful not to overwater it. It doesn't like soggy soil at all. So the potting soil should be an equal mix of garden soil, perlite, sand and vermicompost. And Aglaonemas grow in the summer season, so it is better to fertilize them in the summer season, just before the summer season. Actually, they don't hibernate, but that is the best period to grow. The best period they grow. Actually, watering depending upon where you are keeping. And my plant, I am keeping them outside, even though they are not in direct sunlight, but I have to water them every day because here the temperature has come, it is little bit higher, and so I have to water them every day. So see your according to the place where you are living, you have to make the adjustments. And this is one plant which provides oxygen in the night also, so it is a best plant to keep in the house for the oxygen purpose. Of course, it can't produce all the oxygen, but at least you can, it can give a little bit of oxygen. And if you want to make it bushy, you can always cut the stem, and so that new plants will appear. Here I have not done it, but you can do that. Propagation is by cutting the stem, and then sometimes plants may appear. See, here one small plant is coming. Actually, when I planted, I had only one plant. Now I have two plants and one small one appears. This has only one plant till now. I don't know where. Maybe the summer season started. It will. This is the slow grower, but the other ones are growing nicely. And if you feel that you have neglected the plant and the plant is going to dry off, then what you can do is just leave the green leaves and cut off all the old leaves and keep it in shade and give proper care, then it will come off. It won't die very fast, it won't dry off very fast. Even if for 1 week if you are not watering, it will look very sad, but the plant will make it up. So if you are going out of station and if you have left the plant for 1 week time, there is always a chance of reviving them. So pest attack is there. This mealybugs are the main culprits. If you happen to see them, use neem oil. This plant is actually a little bigger. Beautiful plant. So this is about aglaonemas or the Chinese evergreen. So I have covered almost all the points. You can always comment in the comment section how the video was about. And if you are a first time viewer, consider subscribing. Please like and share the video. Thank you for watching.